In this video, we're going to take a look at how we can add general dimensions to an Autodesk Inventor drawing. I'll begin by selecting my Annotate tab and selecting my Dimension tool here. Very similar to the Part mode, we have one Dimension tool that will apply several different types of dimensions. We can use it to create linear dimensions by simply selecting a line. As you can see, that there's some preset spacing that the dimension will snap to. I can also select two parallel lines to create a linear dimension, once again, just like it is in the part mode. And I can also select two endpoints as well. The same tool can be used to create an aligned dimension. I'm going to go ahead and create an aligned dimension on this angled shape, even though by standards it doesn't really make a lot of sense. But I'll go ahead and select the two endpoints here of this shape. And as you can see, by default, it wants to create some linear dimensions. But depending on where I hold my mouse, if I come in closer to the shape, then I can actually get my aligned dimension instead. We can also use this tool to create angular dimensions. I'll select my dimension tool and select two lines. And you can see the resulting angular dimension that is created. We can also do, in this case, the supplementary angle. But once more, I can go ahead and click to place my dimension. The same tool can also be used to create radius and diameter dimensions. If I select an arc, by default, it's going to give me the radius dimension. And if I select an entire circle, by default, it will give me the diameter. Now, if for some reason you need to adjust that, before placing the dimension, you can right-click, point to dimension type, and switch it to the opposite. So once again, whether you need to create linear, aligned, angular, radius, or diameter dimensions, they can all be done with the General Dimension tool. That concludes this look at placing general dimensions in an Autodesk Inventor drawing.